Today, we'll show how to evaluate support reactions for problems having more than three unknowns. To solve determinate structures with more than three reactions, we need to have additional equilibrium equations. This can be obtained by the presence of intermediate hinges. Also, the presence of link members will provide additional equilibrium equations. Let us first discuss the intermediate hinge. In the previous lecture about internal forces, we explained that if any loaded 2D structure is cut at a point, two internal forces and one internal moment will appear at that point on each side of the cut. We also explained that the presence of the internal forces is caused by the transfer of load effects from one point to another until it reaches the supports. If an intermediate hinge is inserted at a point, the rotation on one side of the point will not be transferred to the other side across the hinge. And if rotation cannot be transferred across the hinge, then moment cannot be transferred as well. This means that if we cut the structure at the hinge location, only two internal forces will appear, and the internal moment will be equal to zero. The fact that internal moment at the hinge is always equal to zero gives us an additional equilibrium equation that can be used to solve complex problems, as will be shown in the examples presented later in this lecture. In our introduction, we talked about link members. So what is a link member, and how can it provide additional equilibrium equations? A link member is a beam that has two properties. It has a hinge at each of its ends, and it has no loads inside the span between the two ends. So what is special about the link member? Let us try to figure this out by cutting the link member CD at point C and D, as shown. Because both ends are hinges, at each end we will have two internal forces, but no moments. By considering the equilibrium of member CD and taking the sum of moments about point D, we find that the force YC should be equal to zero. Similarly, by applying the equation sigma y equals zero, we find that yd should be zero. Therefore, only internal forces in the direction of the member will exist. Now, if we further cut the link into two pieces at point E, two internal forces and one internal moment will appear at each side of E because E is not a hinge. If we consider the equilibrium at part ED, by applying sigma y equals zero, and taking the sum of moments about point D, we find out that both YE and ME should be equal to zero, and they will vanish, leaving only one internal force, XE, in the direction of the link. In summary, if a link member is cut at any point inside its span, this point will only have one internal force in the direction of the member. This, in effect, provides us with two additional equilibrium equations, because both the internal moment and the perpendicular internal force vanish inside the link. Now let us start working at some examples. The following beam has two supports, a fixed support at A and a roller support at B. Therefore, it will have four unknown reactions. For more information about support types and their reactions, refer to the first lecture about the principle of statics. Because we have four unknowns and only three basic equilibrium equations, we need an additional equation. This we can obtain from the hinge at C. This can be done by cutting the beam at point C into two parts. At each part, two internal forces, XC and YC, will appear. Because the original beam is in equilibrium, any part cut from the beam should also be in equilibrium. So we will apply the equilibrium equations on part CB. By applying sigma x equals zero, xc is found to be zero. By taking the sum of moments about point C, we find that both xc and yc pass through point C and will not be included in the equation. The moment equation will have two terms, a 9 kN force multiplied by an arm of 1 meter, negative clockwise, and yb multiplied by an arm of 3 meter, positive counterclockwise. All terms should sum to zero. From the equation, YB is found to be 3 kN. Next, we apply sigma y equals 0 to obtain the value of yc as 6 kN. Now that xc and yc have been evaluated, part AC will have only three unknowns, xA, yA, and mA. By applying sigma x equals 0, xA is found to be 0. By applying sigma y equals 0, we obtain the value of yA as 6 kN. Finally, by taking the sum of moments about point A, the equation will have two terms. Negative yc multiplied by 2-meter arm, and positive MA, which is not multiplied by any arm since it is a moment and not a force. Solving the equation gives MA equal 12 kN meter. Let us look at a second example. The shown beam has a roller support at A with one reaction and a fixed support at E with three reactions, and a surge support at F. Let us focus more closely on F. The support at F looks like the fixed support, but it has a hinge, and therefore the moment at the support should be zero. So the support resembles a hinged support and should theoretically have two reactions, XF and YF. However, F is connected to the beam by the member FB, which has a hinge at each end and no loads in between. Therefore, it is a link member. If we cut the link BF at the middle, it will only have one internal force in the direction of the link. If we consider the equilibrium of the lower part of the link, we will find that the reaction at F should also be one reaction, RF oriented in the direction of the link. We can use the reaction RF directly in our calculations, or we can use its vertical and horizontal components. We will choose the alternative that simplifies the calculations. We have five unknown reactions, so we need two extra equations that will be provided by the hinges at C and D. So we will cut the beam at point C and point D into three parts, and we will apply the equilibrium equations at the three parts. We'll start by applying the equations at part CD. Part CD has four unknowns, XC, YC, XD, and YD. By applying sigma x equals 0, we figure out that XC is equal to XD, but we don't know their values. By taking the sum of moments about point C, we find that XC, YC, and XD all pass through C and will not be included. The equation will have two terms, positive YD multiplied by 2-meter arm, and negative 10 kN force multiplied by 1-meter arm. The equation gives a value of 5 kN for YD. By applying sigma y equals 0, we obtain the value of YC as 5 kN. Next, we apply the equilibrium equations on part AC. First, we will convert the distributed load to an equivalent concentrated force. Since we have already figured out the value of YC, we will have three unknowns in this part, XC, YA, and RF. By taking the moment about point B, we find that RF and XC both pass through point B and will not be included. So we are left with only one unknown, YA. The equation will include three terms, a negative YC multiplied by 2-meter arm, clockwise rotation, a negative YA multiplied by 4-meter arm, clockwise rotation, and a positive 12 kN equivalent force multiplied by 2-meter arm, counterclockwise rotation. All terms should sum to zero, giving a value of YA of 3.5 kN. Now that YA is evaluated, we apply sigma y equals 0, but we have to use the y component of RF. By solving the equation, RF is found to be 22.5 kN. Applying sigma x equals 0 gives XC equal 18 kN. Recalling that XD is equal to XC, XD will also be equal to 18 kN. And finally, we apply the equilibrium equations to the part DE to find the last three unknowns, XE, YE, and ME. By taking the sum of moments about point E, we find that XE, YE, and XD pass through E and will not be included. The equation will include two terms, positive YD multiplied by 2 meter counterclockwise rotation, and negative ME clockwise rotation. All terms should sum to zero, giving a value of ME equal 10 kN meter. Applying sigma y equals zero gives YE equal 5 kN. Applying sigma x equals zero gives XE equal 18 kN. Now that all the reactions have been evaluated, we can apply the equilibrium equations on the whole beam to validate the solution. Let us take the sum of moments about point P for the whole beam. We find that XE and RF both pass through point B and will not be included. The equation will include five terms. Negative ME clockwise rotation, positive YE multiplied by 6 meters counterclockwise, negative 10 kN force multiplied by 3 meters clockwise rotation, positive 12 kN equivalent force multiplied by 2 meters counterclockwise, and negative YA multiplied by a 4 meter arm clockwise. By substituting the reactions into the equation will evaluate to zero as expected, thus validating the results. Let us look at the third example. The shown frame has two hinged supports with two reactions each, making four unknown reactions. By looking at point B, we find that three reactions, XA, XB, and YB, pass through point B. So by taking the sum of moments about point B, these three reactions will not be included in the equation, and only one unknown YA will be left. But before applying the equilibrium equations, we will convert the distributed load to an equivalent concentrated force of 12 kN. The moment equation about point B will include two terms, negative YA multiplied by 6 meters and the 12 kN equivalent force multiplied by 3 meters. Solving the equation will give YA equals 6 kN. Applying sigma y equals 0 gives YB equals 6 kN. After evaluating YA and YB, we are left with two unknowns and only one equation. However, the fourth equation can be obtained by cutting at the hinge at point C. But take care that when you cut at point C, the distributed load is also cut into two parts, and therefore the equivalent force of 12 kN obtained earlier is no longer valid and should not be used. Instead, we should obtain an equivalent force for each part of the distributed load separately, as shown. Now we can apply the equilibrium equations at part CB to obtain the value of XB. Let us take the moment about point C for part CB. We find that XC and YC both pass through point C and are not included. The equation will include three terms, YB multiplied by 2 meter arm, counterclockwise positive, XB multiplied by 4 meter arm, clockwise negative, and the 4 kN equivalent force multiplied by 1 meter arm, clockwise negative. Solving the equation gives XB equal 2 kN. Now, let us consider the equilibrium of the whole frame. Solving sigma x equals 0 for the whole frame gives XA as 2 kN.